Here I am at the film team office with my guest Ravindra Randeniya, Dr. Ravindra Randeniya, on Sequence Y, Anything But with Kumar Iskilpa on www.pulse.lk and sponsored by LICC Jeans. Ravi, your first film was Kalu Diya Dahara, Manik Santosagar's epoch-making film. Now, anyone's first film is always baptism by fire. First time. Was it for you?
Definitely. It was a different experience altogether. And then suddenly we were put into a different world, like continuous 15 days of night shooting in Haputale. So that itself, you know, that
you
was
were raw. You were raw.
Yeah, and that's definitely. Although it was very cold, it was baptism by fire.
Okay. So your first ever screen lip kiss was in that film.
That's right. I think not only mine; it's the first direct lip kiss for the entire Sri Lankan cinema, and it lasted about 2-3 minutes, I think.
Okay. You sound regretful, it's too short. So how many lip kisses have you done in these 7 years, 100 plus films?
Not really lip kisses, but then, well, playing the lead, you always get to
touch the lady and
very, very, you know, amorous scenes.
What has been your most horrible experience shooting a film?
Well, I got shot very badly on my back when I was doing Saradil, and it was touch and go because one of the shrapnel pieces had gone almost near my lungs, and the situation was such I couldn't get immediate medical attention. But anyway, that is the most horrible. I have been lucky enough not to injure myself right through my career, although I did all my stunts myself.
So on your own?
On my own. I have never used a double for my stunts, and then okay. I have done some very, very tricky, serious stunts.
Like what?
Well, jumping off Kalutara Bridge into Kaluganga, right at the center, okay. From on top of the bridge,
okay.
And then going about 20 feet deep and then trying to come out.
Which film was this?
Bambarapetikki. And that is just one. There are so many like that.
What about Veerapurangappu?
Veerapurangappu was a very, very tough film to do because the action was very, very big and demanded a lot of physical strength. But I think another daring one was the train sequence in Siripala Saramanika.
Oh, yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Jumping off from the roof of a train, moving train,
yes.
Onto the ground, not to cardboard boxes or anything, to the ground and then roll off. That was very, very difficult. And we had to do 3 takes because first one was okay, second one was from a different angle, and the cameraman said, for safety's sake, we'll do another one.
For his safety, not for your safety.
Not for my safety.
Did you ever think it was worthwhile risking your life, your limbs, your everything to do these things?
This is the irony of it, you know. If an actor injures himself, you know, he may be out of his
exactly.
profession right
now. Paralyzed for life.
Yeah, it could happen. But then, I don't know, when you get into
that
act.
You married at that time, the kids were born?
Yeah, yeah.
So were you being responsible by the family, now, children?
I was coming to that. You know, when you get into that act and then you can't, you know, when you start going, you can't stop halfway. You've got to go all the way. And you can't, you know, do a scene halfway and say, oh, I'm nervous, I'm a little jittery, I feel a little scared to do this scene or whatever. No. Of course, now looking back at it, I think there have been an element of irresponsibility in doing
all.
Oh,
you do admit it, in a sense, in a larger sense.
In a larger sense, because as I said, it could completely, you know, jeopardize your career completely. And also there are certain other responsibilities, but then once you're an actor, I think those things suddenly move into a second place, and then you are focused on one thing and you go blindly along that path, which is right or wrong, I don't know.
One of your main leading ladies, Mali Fonseca, is a Kalaniya girl. You were in the suburb of Kalani in Dalugama.
Yeah.
Had you all met or crossed each other's paths, you know, before you came into films?
I very, very vividly remember her because after Akal Vassas, she won the Best Actress Award while she was in school, I think. And we used to see this girl because we used to pass her school in the car and she was walking down.
Gurukula.
And then she used to overtake us. The level crossing is there, our cars are stopped, and again we move forward and she's behind us and she's coming again, and we guys are looking at her.
You all put line to her?
I was looking at her very hard, beautiful girl. And I could see that she knew that
he did
we
not
were,
answer that question.
She knew that we were looking at her. She was nervous and tapping her leg with her foot ruler that she was always carrying. he would walk past by.
But so you knew her at that time?
I had seen her. But the strange thing is, even before Kaldi Dhar, Sugathapala Sinrathyappa wanted to do a film, he cast me in that. I think that was Lionel Wendt days. And then Malini was the leading lady. The film never took off.
Okay.
But I remember very nice comment by her much later. They have asked, who's your leading man? She has said, somebody tall and very fair must be a burger boy.
Compliment?
Yeah, I think you can take it as a compliment in a way.
Many years down the line, if you were made the chairman of the Film Corporation, would you turn how would you turn the clock backwards? And what would you do for the Sri Lankan cinema, of which you are a very integral, important part?
Yeah. I don't know why I'm so involved, because I haven't had any other benefit from the industry than being an actor. I mean, that is more than enough to compensate for all other worldly gains for me. But I have never produced a film, never directed the film, never distributed the film, never exhibited the film. Those are the mainstays of the industry.
Sure.
But I'm so involved, I think, since about 1977. And to answer your question, if I were the chairman, there's nothing more to do. There's a very powerful Film Corporation Act of 1971, number 47. If that is implemented...
Why is it not implemented?
This is the question. Not only it is not implemented, certain conditions, regulations that are there in the Act, it's an Act of Parliament, it are being violated openly. And the practice is going on. It is illegal to violate a condition that is in an Act of Parliament.
But Ravi, you have been a presidential advisor. You have worked closely with many governments, many prime ministers and cabinets. So couldn't you advise them?
I have always been consistently on this policy that the Film Corporation Act, which was promulgated for the benefit of the local industry, that we should not deviate from it. That has been my advice consistently and very strongly. I have been even just last week at a meeting of a president's committee. This was my line. I said, there is power in the act to put right all the ills of the industry. Please implement. I have been trying, but then,
no one wants to do it.
It has been a cry in the wilderness. No one hears.
My last question is in this sequence. Ravi, you've been in more than 100 films. Acting with a lot of nice ladies of different shapes and sizes. Today, if you were given a chance of playing a steamy bedroom scene with any one of those ladies in your career of so many years, which one of those ladies would you choose?
I would rather like to put that question back to you.
Why me?
Because I have acted as my girl or wife or my lover or whatever. Starting from Airangani Serasinghe, Anula Karunathilaka, Suinita Veerasinghe, Manil Vanaguru, Nita Fernando, Malini Fonseca, Anuja Veerasinghe, Swarna Mallavarachi, Veena Jayakodi, and Geeta Kumarasinghe, definitely. And after that... And then Vasanti Chaturani, Sabita Pereira,
Yashoda
Vimaladharma, and Sangeeta Veeraratna. Down the line, I think there are so many...
Anarkali
Akasha was the last girl with whom I have acted as husband and wife. So now out of this series, please tell me, which one should I enact that most amorous or whatever steamy love scene I should do with? Please tell me.
Arangani down to Anarkali Akasha. Ravi, in school, you said that you were cast as Kashyapa in grade 5.
Yeah, that was my first appearance.
So that teacher who cast you in that role was prophetic.
Why?
Kashyapa is here.